think one of the first things we're going to do is check out Stone Lake for some duck migrants. Is the ice off the lake yet? I don't know. We'll find out. And I can see that it's only partly off the lake. So a bit of ice here. But yeah. Oh, there's ducks. There's ducks. There's ducks. Now, can we get some video? Ringneck ducks, which really probably should be called ring-billed duck, because that neck band is only really visible in the hand. That said, the ring around their bill kind of fades throughout the breeding season. Well, Nichols Lake is still partly frozen, but I hear signs of spring, like phoebes, tree swallows. There's buffleheads out here. And check out the male's head-pumping courtship display. A pair is on the lake, and then a third male comes in, takes his female back, pumping his head to show off to his female. Rough grouse drumming. Red-winged blackbird, of course. Let's see what else we can find out here.
Common loon.
Ringneck ducks, mallard, drake mallard. Ooh, a pair of loons.
Two.
They're a long ways out. Yeah, no ice on this part of the lake. Aspens are budding out. Got two beavers right here. Extremely mellow. Okay, he's watching me right now. I better get some more of it. And the other one just was scared by a wood duck. Not by me. All right, I'm gonna get some more video. heard that song, Muskrat Love. Isn't it by Captain and Tennille or somebody? Muskrat Charlie, Muskrat Susie. I think that's what we got going on out here. A little beaver love. They're kind of nestling up to each other and yeah, it's almost, oh, there they go. Got a snowshoe hare up here. I tell people they're really hard to see in the winter, really hard to find. So they're back in the woods in dense balsam and dense brush, and they're white and the snow is white. But now this time of year and through the summer, they come out to the road edges early in the morning and graze on the green grass. And looks like this guy is mostly brown, a little bit of white left. Yeah, he's got some white on his feet, white on his ears, a little white on his back, too. Well, I think this is close enough. We'll leave him alone. Found this snipe just wandering around Sachs Road. Note how far back their eyes are on their head. And this really helps when they've got that flexible tipped bill probing down in the mud for earthworms, about their favorite food. You know, very vulnerable position, but with those eyes so far back on the skull, they can see behind themselves for predators. Pretty cool. Wilson's snipe. Belted kingfisher. We've just had an incredible morning birding and mammaling. Is that a word? I don't know. Here on Stony Creek to share with you some exciting news. Very, very exciting. And some sad news. Which do you want to hear first? Okay, I'll give you the sad news first. Sarah, our development director and office person, is pursuing other exciting ventures. And Sarah has been with us for 10 years, almost from the start. And she's what really has helped make this organization run and become what it is today. We will miss Sarah. I'll get to see her. My wife and Sarah are besties, best friends. Thank you. So yeah, Sarah Beaster, we will see you around, but thank you for 10 years. That is so exciting that you're gonna pursue new things. Can't wait to see what you do. But Sarah's gonna continue working on kestrel monitoring, so that's awesome. We have hired another Sarah without an H, Sarah Blank, and she will be our new development and membership director and keep the office running, humming. The exciting news, well, I don't know if I'm gonna share it with you right here. I gotta go up to the spot that's actually involved in this exciting news. All right, let's go. Lots of flickers too, flying off the edge of the road, probably looking for early season ants. They love ants. The roads are a little rough right now. Stuff's gonna start popping here. There's still snow in my ravine at home. So there's a lot of catch up to do phenologically. Everything's gotta catch up in the next 3 weeks, and it will. It'll all catch up by then. Okay, roads are rough. Okay, we are here. There's a sharp shinned hawk. Awesome. So everything now, here's the big surprise. Well, it's not a surprise to some of you, but everything from this point on up Admiral Road, we're on Admiral Road going that way, we own now. Friends of Sax-Zim Bog, thanks to you guys, we have purchased 3,200 acres. It is under a permanent conservation easement per the rules of a wetland bank. Will never be logged, never mined, because we own the mineral rights as well. Well, the mineral rights stay with the wetland bank. But yeah, you can explore, snowshoe, but we can't build anything on it. But we don't want to. This is habitat for great gray owls, Connecticut warblers, and all the other boreal birds we love. So thanks to you guys again and the Acres for Owls Land Fund. All right. Check this out. So everything now in this next time-lapse video belongs to you guys now. So that was it. 3,200 acres, just a part of it. And now we're going to take a look at another part of it from the air. Owls, Connecticut warblers, blackback woodpeckers, boreal chickadees, all gonna benefit from this purchase. Prime black spruce bog habitat protected by a permanent conservation easement. Oh, did you hear that? Brown creeper. Oh, hermit thrush. So yeah, very, very exciting. And this purchase goes all the way over to County Road 7, over to McDavitt. The east side of McDavitt, the west side will be for the purchase we're working on for later this year. Yeah. Let's see if we can get some video of this brown creeper. These are actually the first frogs I've heard all year. This is the first time ever I haven't heard frogs until May. It's been that kind of spring. But yeah, you can hear them. They sound like little weird chickens. You can also hear boreal chorus frogs sound like you're running a finger down a comb. But Clinton has a program this weekend called Things That Go Buzz, Crow, Hoot, and Bump in the Night, and he'll talk about their finds on Facebook, so check that out. Not only some great mammals today, but also some great butterflies. It started out at about 25 degrees this morning, but now up to nearly 50, and they are popping out. And these are all adult hibernators. These are butterflies that in late fall, they find a hidden spot in the woods, or maybe under a flake of bark, maybe in a hollow log, settle in for the long winter. Their body gets flooded, all those cellular spaces, with glycerol, a natural antifreeze, and they can survive 20 below, 30 below, 40 below, 50 below zero as adults. That is crazy. And then in the spring, they pop out, ready to start that next generation of butterflies. Today, we've seen all adult hibernators, like the Mourning Cloak, Eastern Comma, Compton Tortoiseshell, and the Milbert's Tortoiseshell. Pretty cool. The last vestiges of winter. Little snow pile in the parking lot of the Welcome Center. Thanks for joining me on Virtually Live 27. It is May the 4th. Let's see, what May the 4th be with you. Wait, let me do this. Wait, that's Star Trek. Okay, my kids are going to be mortified. May the 4th be with you. Don't forget Cinco de Mayo is coming up, as well as Sitting de Mai. Norwegian Independence Day on May 17th. All right, back to Virtually Live. Eastern Phoebe, they nest under the eaves of the Welcome Center here, which is pretty cool. But I wanted to announce that Richard King has put up a $75,000 match for our addition to the Welcome Center. So your $5, $10, $100 gets doubled, essentially. So thank you to Richard. It's in memory of his wife, Lois. Lois was awesome. She initiated several large donations to Friends of Sax-Zim Bog. So this will be known as the Lois King Educational Space, which I think is a fitting tribute for Lois. Thank you to Dick for putting up that $75,000 match. You can go to our website and click on the Give Your Gift or Donate buttons to be a part of that match. We're going to start construction as soon as road restrictions go off. So stay tuned. I'll give you updates on construction. It's been a fun day. Lots of unexpected stuff. The beavers. In fact, I'm going to have to make the beaver my mammal of the day. Snowshoe hare was pretty good too. But yes, definitely the beavers. The lovey-dovey beavers, for sure. Bird of the day. Maybe that snipe just wandering around in the grass. I think I'll have to give it to that Wilson snipe. Plus, there was lots of them displaying as well. What is that? Insect of the day. It's going to be these butterflies, these adult butterflies coming out of hibernation. The Eastern Comma, Mourning Cloak, Milbert's Tortoiseshell, and Compton Tortoiseshell. But yeah, fun day. Beautiful spring, I think, is finally here. Yeah. So until next time... Ruby Crown Kinglet. So until next time, keep your feet in your rubber boots because it's still kind of wet and mushy out there. And your head up with your binoculars looking for warblers. Where are the warblers? All we've had is yellow-rumped warblers so far. They're coming. All right. Until next time, take care. Have fun. Happy birding. See ya.